never understand.
God is common.
So the why I should bother to worry about you? You and your mind types and all things.
I'm preoccupied. Is it something difficult to understand?
I want to be done with your stuff because you were exhausted.
I was. I'm still exhausted. But the exhaustion is of a different sort.
What rubbish! The exhaustion is of a different sort. What's that mean?
Mother, I must ask that you leave me to my work.
And what work is that, Victor?
Why?
I'm curious. You're curious. And cautious.
Victor,
you're behaving all the time as if you're a man with a deep, dark secret. And you're terrified of someone's going to uncover it.
That's nonsense.
There is not. Every minute, the door, day and night, with boxes of heaven knows what. And then we go speaking to the garden all our way. Don't you think I'm worried about it all? And the lights. The sound. Victor, what is it you hide behind this door?
Nothing that could possibly interest you.
Well, let me be the judge of that.
No!
What is it? It frightens me, Victor.
It's nothing, Mother, it's nothing. You know how I am about my work. That's all.
Victor, you're the man who just looks so down. And what will you be pulling further and further away from me? I don't speak to much of your brother. If I want to, then your father was taken from me and was a great personal tragedy. But I have my dear and I have my William. Then William was taken from me. Have a care, Peter. You've got to take my heart. You are only flesh and blood I have left. If anything should happen to you, I could not bear it.
I'm sorry for anything that might have caused.
And she worries about you too. I don't blame her.
I love her. It's tender.
And who married her?
I've never met anyone that excites my warmest admiration for the way you
listen. Oh, Becky, you could say the same thing about a piece of porcelain.
I mean my words.
I confess. It would be my greatest happiness to see you at the prison of Mary. It would give me strength in my declining years.
Declining years? You're still a young woman.
Oh, I've always thought you were perfectly one another. You've always been so close.
Mother, what is it you're trying to say?
I fear that perhaps you think of existence as a sister without any desire to make her your wife. There, that's what I fear. But whatever lies behind that door.
I swear to you, Mother, my future plans are entirely bound up
with this. What is that? And perhaps this melancholy which has taken over you will dissipate itself.
Victor, this won't do after all. Bruce is too easily. Oh, sorry, Marcus.
What did the papers, Henry?
An idle experiment.
With Bruce's?
It would be of no interest. Perhaps we should go into town, exchange it for one more suit. Yes, yes, I'll get my coat.
Well, if nobody needs it, I'll take his suit with you.
This isn't a shopping trip, Mother. It is not the sort that I would appreciate. Trust me.
I would not, thank you.
All right. Then we're off.
Will you be home for lunch?
That depends on our trip into town.
Oh, you are the despair of something.
And with Elizabeth, and with Henry, and you, and with myself. But that will soon all change.
I pray for it.
Remember, trust me.
My God. I'm years ago going into that laboratory, and I was met by a small army of eating frogs. And then, of course, there was some peculiar, very thin contagion. So I haven't been back since. So it does sound like winter. Even a little bit in front of me. It's just... Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't think. But I think you're all right. It's me all the time. Would you go down to the cellar here?
The cellar?
There's a box on my late husband's coffee table. Bring it up here. She doesn't like to go down there. She's afraid of spiders.
Oh, I'm sure. Oh, yeah.
You know my feelings, George. When my late husband and I became a child, why you were a beautiful child? Abandoned and unloved.
Oh, now that's love. You took me to your heart.
And there's no doubt in my mind that you love my son.
Nor in my mind.
And you're beautiful, thoughtful, gentle, understanding.
You make such virtues, son.
I believe. Oh, I don't think you do. But I think there's a great danger in being too distant.
Do you think Victor thinks of you as a sister?
No, he's good unless you give him the deep that you are upon. With a man like Victor, you're sort of more aggressive, but you know, you, unlike most women, you've got to compete with this kind of spirit. With a man like Victor, that's a formidable rival.
I fear my rival is to be silenced. How long has come in second dust?
And I think you understand me, but even in our that is not enough. Set your mind to your marriage and let nothing stop. There he is. That's the only way. Troublemaker.
Oh, you should have been a matchmaker.
Exactly what I am trying to be. You know, they can't come anymore. And I want you to go out of there. And if they suggest you're intruding where you just go right ahead and do, go on.
But Victor will want to be about his business.
Then make his business. You compete as a man.
But I've never forced myself on Victor.
Exactly. Remember, quickly, decisively.
Total victory.
Oh, Elizabeth.
Is this what you wanted?
Yes. And leave me.
I'm right there.
Yes, I'm fine.